afternoon's game. First of all, for UPEI, the keeper, number 25, Brett McDonald. Number 3, Jared Murphy, wearing number 7, Dylan White. Number 8, Andrew Hughes. Number 11, Logan Dawson. Number 14, Danny Hill. Number 17, Dan McAleer. Wearing number 20, Colby O'Donnell. Wearing number 22, Brad Hogan. And wearing number 23, Josh Bessie. The assistant coach of the Panthers is Bruce Norton. The head coach is Lewis Page in his 11th season. Here now is the starting lineup for your UMB Varsity Reds. The keeper, Aaron McMurray. Wearing number 5, Jason Bessie. Wearing number 7, Amir Razak. Wearing number 8, Shane Nordheim. Wearing number 9, Jean-Claude Campbell. Wearing number 10, Ryan Lozon. Wearing number 11, Rod Ramsden. Wearing number 12, Charles Duplessis. Wearing number 13, Brad Copperthwaite. Number 14, Ben Law. Number 19, Yasuf Jahab Eldin. Wearing number 20, Keelan Smith. The assistant coaches for the Varsity Reds, Dave Rice, John Coslin, and Adam Prescuda. The head coach in his 8th season is Miles Pinson. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to be calling three of our Varsity Reds athletes who are graduating this year. They will be more formally acknowledged by the team at a ceremony after this match. But we would like to thank and congratulate, in his Master's of Engineering degree, Brad Copperthwaite. Bachelor of Business Administration, James Green. And in pursuit of his Master of Education degree, Galen Smith. We thank all three of these athletes for the time and devotion they have shown to the Varsity Reds soccer program and wish them well in all their future endeavors. At this time, we ask that you please rise, remove your headwear, and join us for the playing of our national anthem.
Oh, Canada, we are what we think you are, but you know us all and we. Come far and wide, oh Canada, we stand on ground for you. Take time to look, look what you
for this afternoon's match. The assistants are Dave Marcatulio and Arendt Akakirian. The head official is Simon Purgatory.
So here we are at Chapman Field for this key matchup here with massive playoff implications between the University of Prince Edward Island Panthers and the UNB Varsity Reds. Teams desperately needing a win to keep their playoff hopes alive. UNB sits in fourth place right now, while UPEI is in seventh. But there's only 4 points between the teams, so UPEI could still sneak in with a win today. And UNB basically needs to get a win here. If they do win for UNB, then they will be in the playoffs. They are tied right now with Memorial on 17 points. Memorial is playing a doubleheader with Dalhousie. And if they split, they would, and UNB wins, they will have the same number of points. But If UNB wins and Memorial wins both their games, UNB would finish ahead of Dalhousie and hang on to one of the top six positions. If they end up tied on points with Memorial, they would win the tiebreaker because they did beat Memorial here earlier in the season. So it's touch and go. If it's a tie, all bets are off, and we'll have to wait and see what results are elsewhere. That would certainly knock PEI out of the playoffs for sure, so they'll have to come and look for the victory. So it should be a wide open game. The conditions here at Chapman Field are best described as frigid. There is a very strong wind going towards UNB's goalkeeper in the first half. It's very, very cold when that wind is blowing, and it's very difficult conditions to play in. We just watched the UPEI girls defeat the UNB girls 1-0 in a close-fought match. It really could have gone either way, and it was a very late goal. Anyway, we're underway here at Chapman Field. Ball now with Yassim for New Brunswick, and it's to Ramsden. He's knocked it back across to Yassim. Let's get the play underway. He has a look, and he's going to play that ball forward. And as I mentioned, balls are going to be very difficult to control under these conditions. The balls, sometimes it's hanging up, sometimes it's getting caught in the wind. And players had a difficult time in the earlier game. That ball's played just too far forward there, and McAleer can't get on the end of it. Playing fullback for UNB today, a left back, is Ben Loy. Knocks it in towards Razak. Razak flicks it on to Smith, and Smith flicks it on, but nobody behind Smith, and that's easy to collect for the UNB fullback. And he's launched that forward. Yassim gets a head on it. That's chested forward, but Ramsden cuts it out. Now Bessie has it. He'll find Copperthwaite, who's reclaimed that right back spot. He'll knock that forward. It's cut out, but Smith get a touch, and now it's a little bit scrappy. Referee decides there's nothing wrong with that. Bessie comes back and challenges again for it. Ramsden gets a foot in, and referee Simon Murgatroyd has decided that Bessie did a little too much trying to win that last ball, and has given a free kick to the Panthers. Blowing down towards the UNB goal, anything from inside half is a potential strike at net opportunity. A number of players lined up, and it's sort of knocked in. I'm not sure what that was. I'm not sure if that's a retake because the ball was moving, but with the wind, it's very, and an artificial surface, it's very difficult to keep that ball still. And we saw that a number of times in the previous game too. So that will be a retake. UNB has pushed up to about 25 yards from goal. And the PI defender will take it again. He's going to just hammer that towards goal. Not quite sure what the idea was there. Whatever it was, it didn't work on this occasion. And UNB goalkeeper Aaron McMurray will play this ball back in. So we're 2 minutes into the game. No score. Still teams feeling each other out a little bit. McMurray actually is now back in his net as he comes forward to take this kick. He'll have to keep this lowish, and he does. It's flicked on by Ramsden, but not particularly far. And it was difficult to control there by Hogan. It's near as far as Copperthwaite. He hoofs it forward, and now it's played in towards the left back for PEI. It's Josh Vessey, and that ball has been played out of bounds. So two top goal scorers for these two teams. For UNB, it's Galen Smith. And for UPI, it's Jared Murphy. And both players only have three on the season. So that does give you a little bit of an indication of what the difficulties have been for these two teams. UNB has only got 10 goals on the year, and UPI has only had 11. So just averaging about a goal a game. And now is an opportunity. Razak gets a toe on it. It's chested back and out of bounds. Kind of a surprise surprise opportunity there for Razak. Just sort of suddenly the ball has flicked on, appeared there, stuck his toe out, but was deflected wide. And now Copperthwaite will take the corner. UPI's got men on the post. Galen Smith has been watched closely. He's in front of the goalkeeper. Copperthwaite knocks it in there. It's towards Yassim, and now Smith does get ahead on it. Now it's back in towards Lozen. Lozen gets it back out to Copperthwaite. He'll put the ball back in the box. It's going to go over the top Now it's with Ben Law. Ben Law tries to get it back into the dangerous area. It's cleared by PEI. But this, now it's out towards the left wing, and challenging for that is Hogan. But Copperthwaite has won the... I guess he didn't win the throw-in. Unfortunately for Hogan, he stepped off the turf and attempted to stop on the concrete surround, or tarmac surround, and that didn't go too well for him. Yassin heads clear, but it doesn't get very far. But two PI players collide. Now Lozon has won it for UNB, and he keeps it in. He knocks it forward down the line, but only as far as O'Donnell. O'Donnell has mopped that up nicely and tried to find and found feet there for Murphy. Murphy plays it in towards 13, but Yassin gets it clear. Now it's with Campo. A wild challenge there by number 3 for PEI, Murphy. But, Campo has won the throw-in. Both teams exhibiting plenty of energy here in the opening exchanges. That is actually a free kick for UNB. Copperthwaite takes over to Yassin. Yassin to Ramsden. Plays just behind Ramsden, though, but he's collected. He's put him under a bit of pressure, but now he's done well to find Law. Law's got some space to move forward. Has a chance to get his head up. He's looking for options. Finds Nordheim. Nordheim knocks it to Razek. Razek plays it in towards Smith, but it can't quite find his target. And that ball is through to Brett McDonald, who's in nets for UPI today. And he's got under that one a little bit. He's skied it with the highest of the day so far. Bessie wins it to Smith. Smith, the target man for UNB, as usual. He's found Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite has a look up. Plays it back in towards Bessie, but Bessie can't quite collect. That's run through to the Panther defense. Panther defender knocks that forward. He's found McAleer. McAleer has knocked that forward, but it is an offside call against Andrew Hayes. PI. A couple of the PI boys sporting some pretty good Mohicans out there. Mohican haircut. Should make them easy to identify as the game goes on. Number 3, Jared Murphy. In the left back. I'll try to see who he is. Right now it's Ramsden. Knocks it into Ben Law. Ben Law, nice little turn, but he's overrun it there. And Murphy actually collects that as but Lozon won it back. Knocked in. Lozon again, tidying up for UNB. Oh, and there's a mistake by the UPI defender, but he manages to get away with it. That was Danny Hill. He recovered well. Now it's with Hogan again. It's won by UNB. Smith has it. Tries to play it through to Bessie, but it's cut out. And played in towards the corner, but Ben Law gets his head on it. Now it's with Yassin. Yassin manages to get his head on it. And he's cleared the ball, but only as far as Hogan. Hogan down the line, but Copperthwaite manages to get there just before Hayes, but he has conceded the throw-in. Thrown in by the Panthers, only as far as Yassin. Yassin manages to find Smith. He controls, but it was just a little too high for him, and he's been picked up now by Michael Walker, but won back. Now Campo has it. It's not a particularly good ball. It's easily cut out by the Panther defense. Now forward, but... Ramsden has won that, and he's played a lovely ball in towards Smith. If Smith can get there, and he can get there in front of the keeper, but a great save there by McDonald. Good goalkeeping. Came out fast, very decisive, spread himself, and made the save. So Law comes forward for UNB, take the throw in. Still zeros here. We've played almost 8 minutes. Law will throw it in, probably look for the target of Galen Smith. He does that. Smith flicks it on. Nordheim is under it, but he can't quite get it. Lozon has a has an effort there that is high and well over the bar. First real shot of the game, though. So McDonald for the Panthers will take this kick. And once more, the wind has blown the ball outside, you know, off the spot. And this is going to be an issue all game, I think, with the conditions. As I said before, it's very cold and very, very windy out there for the players. It's going to make it very difficult to control this ball on the artificial surface. Flicked on there by Walker. The UNB goalkeeper is going to come. Just gets there ahead of Murphy. Murphy, as I mentioned, the top scorer for PEI this year, although he does only have 3. But still, he's going to be a threat. McMurray puts the ball down. He's looking for some options. Nudges it forward. Decides to kick long. goes towards Nordheim, but it's now flicked on by Razet. Razet to Smith. Smith has looking at opportunities. Oh, plays it back inside to Bessie. Bessie shoots. Very good opportunity there. Excellent ball by Smith. And good strike by Bessie looking for the opportunity, but he couldn't get it wide of the big frame of McDonald. Now it's a long kick, and they're going to let that go all the way through to McMurray. So first good chance of the game there for UNB. Now McMurray puts the ball down again, as he is wont to do. And he's going to fire that forward towards Amir Razak. Razak gets ahead on it, but he can't direct it where he would like to. Now it's with number 17, McAleer, for UNB, for the Panthers. Now it's played back. And that is played down the line, but Law wins it to Nordheim. Nordheim's going to try to protect that. Still got it. He's done well. But now he has been dispossessed, but referee Simon Murgatroyd has given the free kick. So the owner of the other Mohican haircut is Dylan White, native of Charlottetown. He's playing right back for the Panthers. Ball over with Copperthwaite now for UNB, and he's put it forward to Campo. Gets a little nudge in the back, but it goes undetected. Ball now with the Panthers, flicked on down the line, but Yassin is over there. He's put that ball into the car park, and in the old days that would have necessitated a 4 to 5 minute delay, but these days a new ball is in bounds. Panthers on the left wing trying to make something happen. Nice little dummy there. The ball's now through with Hayes. Hayes knocks it in. McMurray's come. Oh, did well there to take that under some serious pressure by the Panthers forward. Looking for options. Decides to put it down. Some little bit of pressure, but he just strokes that ball out to Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite lays it forward. It's cut out, but it's now back with Lozon. Lozon tries to get it forward, but he can't. Now the Panthers come forward, and there's Murphy. Murphy cuts it through to Mac. Ooh, great opportunity there for Dan McAleer, and he just steers that past the far post of Aaron McMurray. Now both teams have had a good scoring chance. McMurray trying to spot this ball up. It's moving on him again. And the Panthers are making an early substitution. On for the Panthers is Adam Lothar. And off, I believe, that is the Dan McAleer, who just had that excellent opportunity. I'm not sure what necessitated that substitution so early in the game. Maybe we'll see McAleer back, or maybe he's carrying an injury or something. We'll see. Well won by Lozon. White will take the throw again. Looks down the line. It's in towards Murphy. Now Mrazek's up, challenging with Murphy. The ball comes down. It's won by the Panthers. Murphy has it again, flicks it forward into the corner. That ball will maybe be kept in by Copper. Yes, he's kept it in. Looking for Campo. Campo, nice turn there. Knocks that forward towards Smith. Well collected by Smith. But it has been won. Oh, yes, but the Panthers win that back. Get the numbers over there on the left-hand side, but it is a throw-in for the Reds. Copperthwaite to take it. 0-0. Early in this first half, we played about 13 minutes. Copperthwaite throws it down the line towards Campo. Campo manages to get a piece of it, but goes to Smith, but he's dispossessed. Now plays in towards Murphy, but won there by Yassim, and now Campo has it. And he's nudged it down the line, but cover is there for PEI in the frame of Colby O'Donnell. And Campo bangs into him and gives away a free kick. I think it looks like O'Donnell's going to stay over there to take this. UNB with plenty of guys behind the ball. That ball is driven forward. It's won by Logan Dawson. Now it's popping around in the midfield. Lozon gets a foot on it. Still up in the air. Smith will come and challenge. Isn't able to win it. Now Nordheim does win it. Now Smith still in there battling. It's a bit scrappy right now. Ball forward. Yassin gets ahead on it. Hogan's gone over there to challenge Campo and has given away the throw-in. Campo leaves that for Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite has a look for his options. And that ball is into Smith, but he can't corral it. He was dispossessed by Walker. Now the ball's played forward to Hayes. Hayes has got some speed. Can he keep that in, though? I don't think he did. Well, I guess he did. Looked to here like it might have just crossed over the line, but the linesman was in line, and he didn't see it that way. And he's flagging now for a substitution to get McAleer back into play. So maybe it was just an equipment problem that McAleer had, but hasn't been seen yet, and the ball's knocked in there, and that has gone out for a goal kick. So maybe now we'll have a chance to make the substitution. Both of these teams coming off back-to-back losses last weekend, so that's also had, you know, a serious impact on their playoff opportunities. UNB lost to Dal, which you know, Dal is one of the top teams in the league, but it was a narrow 1-0 loss. And then went to Acadia, who had only one win on the season, and came out of that with a 1-0 loss as well. So pretty disappointing weekend for UNB, whereas UPI lost a doubleheader to Memorial, which has put a dent in their hopes. So both teams looking to bounce back here today. Now McMurray will take the kick. That ball is up in the air, and it's been pretty much stopped by the wind. And there's some challenges going in, but a free kick to UNB. I guess Murphy didn't hear the whistle. So he's knocked that ball into the corner. We'll have to get a new ball in play. Looks like Ramsden will take this at the back for the Varsity Reds. Sizes up his options. UNB got plenty of shirts forward. Knocked in towards Smith. Smith will get a little flick. And is Razak in? The goalkeeper's come and got it. Now Smith has it. Now Razak has a chance. He's hooked it back. And it's just gone out of bounds. So a bit of a scramble there. Opportunities for UNB. But nothing doing so far. Game tied at zero. We've played 16 minutes. Just a little over. Very cold day here up at Chapman Field. Very windy, difficult conditions to play in. Both teams needing a win to get their playoff hopes a boost. With a win, UNB will be in the playoffs next week in Moncton. Without a win, it will be very difficult for them to make it. It will depend on the outcome of the other games this weekend. Now, this is with Nordheim. Nordheim plays this over towards Razak. And Razak is trying to keep that ball in, but it's been guided out of play there by Dylan White. White throws it down the line. He gets to his McAleer, who's just come back on, and he gets a thump in the back by Ben Law and earns the free kick. And Razak's going to have to back up a few yards before this ball is played in by Colby O'Donnell, who seems to be the free kick specialist for the Panthers. Panthers with plenty of guys lined up on the 18, but that ball doesn't get to them. It's cut out by Bessie. Flicked back in, though, towards Campo and Nordheim get mixed up, though. And now Law, and now that's a great shot. Ooh, just passed. Nice effort there by the Panther number 11, Logan Dawson. Don't know whether McMurray had that covered or not. Hard to say from here. He'll be relieved to find out, though, that it did go past the post. So we're still tied at zero. McMurray to take the kick. Maybe waiting for the wind to die down. He'll have to wait a long time. Now McMurray will launch this one forward as it gets caught up in the wind again. Galen Smith comes over to try to challenge. But that ball is won cleanly by Michael Walker. Now Walker's played that forward to Hayes. Hayes trying to put a few moves on Copperthwaite. Finally puts it back, but it's half won by UNB. Only as far as Walker again. Now it's chipped into the box. It's a good-looking cross. Ramsden gets up, heads it away, but not too far. Yassim completes the clearance. Now Campo gets a foot in, but it's back in by Walker, and now in towards McMurray. So UPEI with the wind in their favor in this first half, as would be expected, is getting the better of the territorial advantage. Now the ball's with Copperthwaite. UMB's had plenty of possession, but most of it has been fairly deep. Now with Yassim towards Ramsden. Ramsden's got plenty of space here. PEI just playing with the one man up front to apply some pressure. Nice little turn by Nordheim. Can he make something of it? He's gone back as far as Lozon. Lozon's played the ball long and towards the corner, but it's got held up in the air. And O'Donnell came over and made that tackle. Lozon intercepted his clearance, but he couldn't corral it. Now Murphy has it, but he's been dispossessed by Campo. Campo to, I think that's Nordheim in the middle. Oh, Camp. That was to Bessie. And Bessie has won the free kick for UNB, so UNB will see what they can do with this. And again, it'll be Copperthwaite to take it. He thought about a short one. It's still on. So he's given it to Ramsden. So we'll change the point of attack, see if this can confuse the Panthers' defense. Now, Ramsden plays it in, but it's a fairly aimless ball, and that is whacked clear and will go right through to the UAB goalkeeper. So McMurray gathers. Game tied at zero. Ball played out to Yassim. Yassim's having a look upfield, knocks it up. Again, it's caught up in the air. Smith is under it. He's got basically a free header, so he decides to bring it down. But UMB has lost it, but now Nordheim's won it back. Nordheim has a chance to run at the PI defense. He's going to go towards the byline, but it's well defended there by Dylan White. Now White knocks it forward, and UNB has won it back. Law has it. He beats his man. He's managed to keep the ball in. He's looking for options now. Plays it forward, but that ball's cut out. But if that is won by Bessie, that would have been a good opportunity for UNB to counterattack. Now it's played forward by Logan Dawson, but no PEI player can get on the end of it. And Copperthwaite has kept that ball in play. Now he looks up, he plays it towards Smith, but he can't get there. Then Lozon goes in to challenge Murphy. Murphy goes round Lozon, but it's picked up by Copperthwaite. But referee Murgatroyd has decided that there was Murphy was impeded, and so he has won the free kick. Looks like Murphy's going to take this on himself, and this time they're going to put Colby O'Donnell in the box to see if he can get on the end of it. And he's actually taken a shot on net, but that's easy for McMurray to collect. So as I mentioned before, these two teams have met before this season. UNB prevailing at PEI at a 1-0 scoreline. That was then, though. This is now. So that ball's up towards White. White's defended that well, headed it clear. But it's only now gone as far as Nordheim. Nordheim tries to get it in towards Smith. The ball's now collected there by Lother. And Razek gets over, gets a foot in, puts that ball out of bounds. But it is a throw in for the Panthers. White throws it down the line, flicked on there. But only is to Dawson, but Law gets a piece of it, and it's out of bounds. The ball's played into the midfield. Lothar knocks it back. It's up. Now Razek has it. Razek has a look. He's managed to find Lozon. Lozon plays a nice ball out towards Nordheim. Nordheim's defending, knocks it back towards Razek. It's just overhit it a little bit, but Razek manages to get a foot in, keep possession towards Law. Law tries to find Lozon, but it's cut out. PI has won it back. Ooh, and it just couldn't quite get that ball through to McAleer. Now Smith has it. Now Nordheim. Nordheim, I think, tried to switch the play there towards Campo on the right wing, but the ball got held up in the wind and became an easy one for the goalkeeper to take. And he has kicked that 75, 80 yards downfield. Copperthwaite gets his head on it and puts it out of bounds. That ball two is in the car park, and will be a new ball in. As UPI looks for options, Lozon's actually taken that off the toe of Murphy, plays it forward, but it can't quite play Smith in, and that ball has run right through to Brett McDonald. So McDonald will have a look at his options. Decides to kick long. Yassin has won that in the air. He's very strong in the air, but it's only as far as the PEI player, I believe that's Dawson. Dawson to White. White down the wing. But Law has won it. Lozon completes the clearance. Now but it's won back by UNB, by Nordheim. Now there's another collision in the midfield. And another free kick to PEI. That's Danny Hill there that won that one. So Colby O'Donnell will take this kick. Trying to play this ball in. Use the wind to his advantage. UNB's keeping a line about 20 yards out, and it's chipped just in towards that line. Nice flick on. That's but three UPEI Panthers offside there, but since the ball went through to McMurray, they will play the advantage. McMurray puts the ball down, looks at his options. He'll come under a little bit of pressure by Andrew Hayes, so he decides to kick. But hasn't gone too far, but now Smith is trying to win possession back for the Reds. But the ball's only gone as far as McAleer. Now played forward towards Hayes, but Ramsden is there, and he wins the free kick. Ramsden plays the ball to Ben Law. Ben Law has a look, plays it back across to Yassim. Yassim has plenty of time and space. Plays it back over towards Ramsden. Ramsden has a look up. Murphy comes to provide some bit of pressure. Tried to play it down the line, but to Walker cut that out. And now won back by Bessie. Ramsden plays it to Campo, but Campo can't quite keep it in. And so that is a throw-in for the Panthers. We've played 25 minutes. Game still tied at zero. Now Lozon has it. Knocks it forward towards Smith. Smith can corral it, but can we keep possession? Yes, Campo has it for UNB now. He's going down the line, but a good tackle there by the Panthers fullback. But UNB has the throw-in. Bradley Copperthwaite will come forward to take the throw-in from his right-back spot. For the Reds, undoubtedly will look for the target of Galen Smith in the box, and UNB will try to get some bodies around there, but he's well held up by O'Donnell, and that ball's easily collected by the UPEI keeper, Brett McDonald. He'll take a look and kick this long. The wind is carrying that, but Yassin gets a piece, but not a very good piece. But now Lozon gets it towards Bessie. Bessie is caught, but he's managed to get it to Nordheim. That's not a particularly good ball. And Razak did well to get a piece of that and just fend off the challenge of White and win the throw-in. Ben Law comes forward to take it. He's knocked it into Nordheim. Back to Law. Down the line. But that's... now Razak has it. Razak's going to take his man on, but he really has nowhere to go. And White snuffs that attack out fairly easily. But throw in for UNB. Law comes forward to take it. Game tied at zero. Law looking for some options. A little bit of movement. Smith's coming forward. He'll be the target. Can't quite get it there. And that ball is cleared out for another UNB throw in. Law will come forward and take this one too. UNB with four guys in the box. They've only really got the lone striker that's playing up front. Now it's in towards Smith, but that ball is headed out for a corner. Corner conceded by Danny Hill, native of Charlottetown, as the majority of this PI Panther team is. Amir Razak grew up in Iraq, but that ball's now with Law. Law puts it in towards Smith. Smith gets a piece of it, but he can't evade the challenges of the UPI defenders. Lozon heads it forward. Nordheim has it now. He'll knock it back to... now we've got Lozon. Lozon to Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite has a shot. At least I think it was a shot. But it is a throw-in, regardless, to the Panthers. McDonald will spot this one up and knock this one forward. Both teams needing a win here today. The tie will really not do either team any good. UPI will be out of the playoffs unless they can win. UNB will likely be out of the playoffs unless they win. That ball is cut out by Smith as far as Campo. Campo, can he keep it in? He can, but he's got the attentions of the PI defense on him. Tries a little spin move, but the ball just does drift out of play. PI throw-in on the far side. goes down the line. Lozon has won it, as he often does for UNB. Copperthwaite gets a foot in. Good challenge in there, but Lothar has won that back for PEI. And the fullback will come forward to take this. Looks for options. He's got Dawson making a move. It's in the corner. I think that was Murphy. He was aiming for possibly Hayes. Lots of movement again as Lothar comes close. The ball is won by Nordheim. Nordheim finds Razek, but Razek's got the attentions of White. It's deep in his own half. He may, you know, he does try to go around and White gets a piece of it, and the ball goes out for a throw-in for UNB. Ben Law to take. Looks for his option. Familiar ball to Smith. Smith gets away with one there, I think. But UNB has turned the ball over, and White clears towards Hayes, but Yassim has won that. Now Law. Law knocks it forward down the line. Razek keeps it in. Now he's beat White, but White's back. He's got the attentions. It's one-on-one. The two number sevens come together. White gets a foot in, but he has conceded the corner. So can UNB make something of this corner around about the 30-minute mark? Game tied at zero. Both teams needing the win. Looks like Razek will take the corner kick himself. UNB has a group of guys towards the back of the 18-yard box, a couple more on the edge of the area, and PI has everybody back inside the 18-yard box. Razek takes the corner. It's well swung in. Looks like Law got ahead, you know, got his head to that, but couldn't direct it down, and that'll be the goal kick for PEI. Goalkeeper Brett McDonald will take this as he spots it up. Looks like he's trying to get a spot on the artificial turf there to keep this ball. UNB makes a substitution. Off comes Razek, and on is Will Allen. So a good 30 minutes for Razek. He's been in and out of the side with injuries this year, so fitness could be a factor. Will Allen's a very hard-working player. See if he can make a difference. Here is Allen. Plays the ball in towards Campo. Campo, a little bit of space. Murphy closes him down. Puts a little bit of a challenge on him. And he'll claim that was shoulder to shoulder, but referee Murgatroy sees it differently. And Copperthwaite will take. Copperthwaite with plenty of red shirts to aim for. Upfield. See if anything can come of this. He tried to play it in low. And looked like the UPEI player Logan Dawson got dragged back there. And UMB has conceded the free kick. And it looks as though Colby O'Donnell will take this for the Panthers. Pretty good rivalry between these two teams over the years. Ball forward. Ramsden heads it clear. Will Allen has corralled it. But McAleer gets a foot in, but only good enough to win concede the throw-in. And here he is down the line. That ball has been played in. At Hill can't keep it in. Now it's with McAleer, but the free kick has been conceded. And Ben Law will take this. Unless, Allen's come over to confer with Law. But I believe this will be Law swinging this one in towards the back of the far, towards the far post. Ball again, once more, has been blown away by the wind. Difficult conditions to play in today. Very cold out there. We've played 33 minutes. We are tied at zero. UNB has actually plenty of options short here if they wanted to change things up. Still struggling to get that ball to stay on the spot. Maybe they should take it short so we can get this ball in play. And might have to have a football play here and have somebody put their finger on top of the ball and get this get the ball back into play. One of the drawbacks of artificial turf, I guess. So he has actually played it short now towards Ramsden. Ramsden will size things up, and he has a poke from there. But it's gathered comfortably by Brett McDonald in the Panthers' net. So as you can see, the conditions really taking a toll on the players here and having an impact on the game. That ball is as far as Law. Good kick. Law tried to find Allen, but White collected. Now Allen wins it in the air against Hayes, and Lowe's on attempts to win it. Now it's towards Bessie. Bessie and Murphy battle for it. Bessie gets it, but I think he's overhit Copperthwaite, and Copperthwaite can't keep it in. And so UNB concedes a throw deep in their own half. PEI fullback will stroll forward to take this. Some movement in the box as he looks for Dawson. But Yassim get there first. Bessie gets ahead on it. That ball is then cleared. But only one UNB player up front, and the ball wasn't to him. A little flick on there. Ooh, dangerous play there. Nice little flick. I think it was Dawson. It looked to me like the UNB fullback got his foot in, but nobody complained when a goal kick was given. So maybe it was Hayes that got a piece of it. And Aaron McMurray in the UNB net will take the kick with the game still tied at zero. UNB kicking into a very strong wind here on this cool day. He's kicked that. It hung up in the wind, made it to about half. But PI has cleared it, and Lozon nudges it forward, but only as far as O'Donnell. But he can't keep the ball in play. Now Copperthwaite comes forward to take the throw in. UNB searching for an opening here, needing the win. Both teams needing the win to keep themselves in the playoff picture. Throws it in towards Smith. Smith can't get on it. It's only cleared as far as the Panthers' back line. Now played into feet towards Bessie. Bessie gets a challenge in there. She has won the free kick. That was Michael Walker. Didn't look to be too serious a challenge, but I think Walker just perhaps gave a little bit too much of a shoulder there. So PI is setting up a four-man, looks like a three, maybe a four-man wall here. And as UNB sizes this one up, if it is Copperthwaite to take it, I don't think he'll be shooting. But Campo is over there as well, having discussions. Maybe he fancies his chances from that range. It's 25 yards out, so it's a good spot to be in, but it is a little bit wide as well. And against the wind, we'll see. And it's knocked in towards Yassim, but good header there by McAleer to get that ball clear. Now Nordheim has collected it, though. Can he get a cross in? Oh, he's gone past his man. And he tries to flick it in. It's in towards. Nice little turn by, I think that was Will Allen. Maybe it was, actually, it was, I think it was Galen Smith actually get the turn in. But it's been cleared. Now Ramsden has it. He knocks it forward, but it's only to a PEI player. And now I think that's Dawson who can break for PEI. Gets a little tug back there by Allen, but maintains control. White goes to White, and he punts it in towards the UNB net. But that's easy for Aaron McMurray to collect. In the previous game of this doubleheader, the UPEI ladies team defeated the UNB Varsity Reds with an 86th-minute goal. And that was the only scoring of the game. Now, battling in the midfield is Bessie. Lozon gets a foot on it. Copperthwaite keeps it in for the Varsity Reds. Looks at his chance. He's under pressure from Murphy. Tries to find Smith. Can't do it. It's cut out by the Panthers' defense. But only to concede a throw-in, which Copperthwaite will take. I hazard to say that Copperthwaite probably leads the AUS in throw-ins this year. But this one is a free kick. So he will try to put this into a dangerous area and put the UPEI defense under some pressure. And it's held up in the air, so this will be a good one to win. But two UNB guys getting in each other's way, neither wins it. Now two more UNB guys getting in each other's way. But now the ball is back with Ramsden. Oh, nice turn by Law. Nice dummy by Law, but unfortunately the angle on the ball wasn't good enough for him. And it ran out of play. White has thrown that down the line. Now it's with McAleer. McAleer turns in front of his man, but Law gets a good foot in, but it's won back by McAleer. But now Ramsden will attempt to complete the clearance, and he puts his left foot through it, and it's gone as far as Will Allen, and Allen has found Bessie. Bessie almost turned that ball over in a dangerous spot, but managed to recover enough to put a foot through it and give the throw-in away. So on the left-hand side, Josh Vessi will take the throw-in. And he's found Walker. Walker back to Vessi. Vessi tries to play that through, but he got his communications crossed up there with the of the Panther forward. And the ball's gone harmlessly through to McMurray. McMurray will have a little stroll around his 18-yard box, force Murphy to come towards him, and then he picks it up. Now he looks for his options. Now he puts it down again. He's looking to see what he can make with this. He's launched it forward towards Nordheim. Nordheim loses out on that aerial battle, though. Now it's with White. White looks for his right winger there. That's Dawson. Dawson tries to flick it by Law, but and it has come off his foot, and he has won the throw-in. So McAleer and Dawson on this near side for PEI. Murphy in the middle. And the ball's thrown into Murphy. Murphy's controlled it. He's got a man on him, but he's played inside, but that's picked off by Nordheim. Nordheim tries to go down the line, but White forces him wide. Interesting tackle there by Lothar. But it's won by UNB and by Law, but he was being fouled and has won the free kick, which he'll take himself. So this game knotted at zero, both teams needing the win to progress. Law will take the free kick. He doesn't have much to aim for up front, so he takes it short, goes to McMurray. McMurray will have a look. Hayes comes to put some pressure on him. He decides to kick long towards Campo, but that has drifted out of play on the far side. And that will be a throw-in that Vessi will take for the Panthers. And he throws it down the line towards Murphy. It's flicked on. But UNB has put in a challenge, attempted to win it back, but just given away a throw-in. And Dawson is over there, but he's left that ball for, I believe it's Josh Vessi to take. And now the Panthers will make another substitution. Coming on, it looks, is, I think that's Brett Hogan coming on. Murphy is coming off. Brett Hogan is going on. So that'll likely be a straight forward. Throw in for PEI. We have played 41 minutes of this matchup. Ball thrown in. Well defended by Copperthwaite. But Josh Vessi will simply take that again for the Panthers. Throws in towards, can't see who. An effort there, kind of misstruck. Easily collected by McMurray. McMurray puts the ball down as he likes to do. Sizes up his options. Under a bit of pressure from Murphy, puts that forward. And the ball's knocked out of bounds. So I'm thinking maybe, looks like Murphy's still on the field. Maybe that was Hayes that was substituted. Throwing for Copperthwaite for UNB. He will undoubtedly try to find Galen Smith. This time he's tried to go into Lozen, but it's a difficult one for him, and he's miskicked it, and it's cleared, but Ramsden has won it back for Copperthwaite. This is a useful spot for Copperthwaite. He's under some pressure, but he's put a good ball in, but that's well cut out by Hill, and now it is with Murphy, and Murphy knocks it forward. Copperthwaite has won it, but it's come off the UPI player, and now it's with Lothar. Lothar's been forced back, though, and he's found the fullback, Vessi, who plays it forward to the substitute. Now is a good opportunity for PEI, and a chance to have a shot, and he has got a good one, but it's just whistled a couple of feet past the post, so UNB escaping there. So we'll try to get this ball back into play. As we move towards the end of the first half, we've got about 3 minutes left, plus any stoppage time. McMurray will kick the ball forward. Not likely to get a lot of distance in this wind. That is well won there by McAleer. But only as far as Law. Law to Nordheim. Nordheim flicks on. And O'Donnell manages to get it forward. But Lozon has picked it up for UNB. Plays it back to Yassim. Yassim to Ramsden. Ramsden gets a chance to get his head up. He'll look for a target. Can't find something he likes, so he puts it to Law. This time he will have to knock it under pressure. Goes forward towards Smith. Smith has left that now for Bessie. Lozon back to Bessie. Bessie again. Bessie tries to play it inside towards Lozon, but it's easily picked out by the Panthers. Now Murphy has won it. He's escaped his man, but there's too much cover from UNB for that to be useful. Now McMurray has it. Picks it up. The UNB keeper in his first year in the AUS conference. All the way over from BC, I believe. Anyway, he's kicked that forward. That is to Smith. Smith tried to find Campo. Couldn't quite do it, but it's Copperthwaite has come forward. Now Campo does have it. Campo, inside his man, finds Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite knocks it into the corner, but there's nobody there for UNB. But not sure why, but that O'Donnell decides simply to play that out of bounds. I guess safety first. Looked like he had a little bit more time, though, if he'd wanted to get that ball under control and try to play that forward. Anyway, Copperthwaite has the throw. Goes in towards Smith. Smith gets a flick, but O'Donnell in behind him. Gets it cleared. Now Ramson controls. He will look for a UNB man. Finds Will Allen, but Allen's dispossessed, I think, by Lothar. And now PEI has won it. Forward towards Murphy. Oh, it's flicked on there. If the speedy McAleer can get there, he can't. Ramson just gets there ahead of him, and he's found Law. And Law now back into McMurray. And McMurray has a chance to corral that for the Reds. Finds Ramsden. Ramsden has got his head up, looking for some options. Can't see much, so he just knocks that forward towards Nordheim. Nordheim can't corral it. Finally, Lozon gets it forward, but White gets it back. Now that ball's over the top, but Ramsden cuts it out. Plays it over towards Campo. Campo kept it in, but it's only as far as O'Donnell. Now O'Donnell will play that ball forward. That looked like a foul, and it is. So PEI has a free kick. Hogan taken down there by Campo. Now O'Donnell will take this for the Panthers. Lined up about the 20-yard line is the UNB defense, trying to actually push it up to 25. It's chipped in, and the flag is up for offside. And it's rolled out of play anyway, so I think, I don't know for sure if we're playing a goal kick here or the original offside. Looks like we will have the offside. So the first half is winding down. I don't know how much time we have added on, but we are into time added on. We've played about a minute of that right now. These two teams locked at zero, which doesn't do either of them any particular favors in terms of making it into the playoffs. So we'll have to see things open up. Nice challenge by Will Allen. Now Bessie has it. A chance possibly before this half ends. Good strike by Bessie, but just over the bar. And I have to be honest and say that I think keeper Brett McDonald had that all the way. So McDonald has another ball, spots this up. We'll take the goal kick. 0-0 here, this game. Donald kicks that. Campo gets a piece of it. Gone straight up in the air, though. And that ball will run out of bounds. Hogan lets it go. And the Panthers have a throw-in. The Panthers defender, Josh Vesey, takes that. And that is halftime. So, 0-0 at the half. We'll see what happens in the second half. And I'll be back in 10 to 15 minutes.
Thank you. Giants up 14-3.
Here we are back at Chapman Field for the second half of this contest between the UNB Varsity Reds and the UPEI Panthers. The game tied at zero. Both teams desperate for a win to get them into the playoffs. For UNB, it would assure them a place in the playoffs. For PEI, they would still have to rely on other results. The earlier game was 1-0 to UPEI ladies. And UNB has now kicked this one off as we move forward towards Nordheim. He flicks that into the corner, but he can't evade Danny Hill, and Hill puts it up the wing. But Law stopped that, and now it's with Allen. Allen puts it forward to Smith. There's nobody in the middle, though, so the UNB have to get it right. Now in comes Bessie. Good cross in by Smith. Law has punted that one high and wide. We mentioned in the first half that the conditions here are very difficult for the teams. Very windy, very cold, and the ball's really bobbling around in the wind, making it a little bit difficult. And as you can see from that kick, it's not going very far when you're kicking into it. UNB has the wind at their back this half, so they do have a little bit of an advantage if as far as getting the ball forward. But it will be difficult to control. Murphy Lee... concedes the free kick. Bradley Copperthwaite for UNB. Looks like he's going to... Is he going to leave that for Ramsden? Or he's, look, Ramsden's got some space here, so he's going to give it to Ramsden. Ramsden's got a chance to knock this ball in from a better angle with his left foot. Didn't go quite as planned. Now Copperthwaite wins the header. It's in towards nice flick on. Smith has now got it up in the air, but good challenge by O'Donnell. Colby O'Donnell winning that one fair and square, says the referee. Ramsden has it. Plays it in. Only as far as Hill. Hill clears. Law wins it. Hill wins again. That's Bessie. Bessie gives away... Somebody gave away a free kick. Not sure who it was. By the body language, I'm thinking it could have been Galen Smith. So UPI will have a free kick. Colby O'Donnell will take it. He's going to steal a few yards while the referee's back's turned. And he knocks that ball out onto the right-hand side. That's for White. White knocks it in. There's an opportunity, but Ramsden gets it clear, and that is quite the clearance. And the ball will run harmlessly through to Brett McDonald in the UPI net. McDonald has it in his hands. It'll be interesting to see if UPI tries to work the ball forward through their fullbacks more this half, because it is difficult to kick into that window. That's a pretty good kick by McDonald right there, but Yassim wins it. Now it's with Will Allen. Allen shrugs off one challenge. He's still going forward. Good chasing back there by the UPI defender. Murphy challenges. Ramsden gets across there and puts the ball and the man into touch. And UPI, though, will get the throw in for that. White comes forward to take it for the Panthers. Desperate for a win here. Throws it into the corner. Ball in there with Dawson. Dawson trying to go put against Law. Gets a little cross in, but mistake by Nordheim. And it's in with the Panthers striker, but rescued by Copperthwaite. And now the Panthers have it again. The ball's gone out wide. Can McAleer keep it in? No, he can't. But Nordheim, I think he thought he'd won the ball there, so let it come across his body, but UPI player was in there behind him and ended up in a good goal-scoring chance for the Panthers. UNB throw-in just around the halfway mark. Ben Law will take it. Law is, I believe, in his second year playing for UNB. It's a good long throw down there, but it's well defended by White. But Allen has come back to pressure. Ball forward towards Murphy. Murphy chests it down but can't control it completely. Law wins it. Plays it to Yassin. Yassin's at a stretch, but he just managed to get it clear. Now Nordheim has gathered it. Can we keep control? He does, but he plays it to Murphy. Murphy now has a chance to get turned, but he doesn't have too much support, so he holds it up. Now a little back heel there, but it goes only as far as the UNB player, who then turns it over. And we have a yellow card, I think, for handball there. I'm thinking that's McAleer. I'm not sure if that's McAleer or Walker. I think it may be Walker that's got the yellow card for PEI. First one of the game. Early in the second half. Time's knotted. The two teams are knotted at zero. Ramsden will take this kick. As he looks forward, he has the wind behind him. Puts it up into the area towards Smith. Well defended by O'Donnell. But Bessie has it on this near side. He has support, but he turns his man. Can he get the cross in? Well defended by McAleer. And the ball... Sorry, that's not Mac... Well defended by Josh Vessie. But a corner kick for UNB. Copperthwaite to take. Looking for the UNB targets in there. Flows in. It's a nice looking cross towards the far post, but flicked to safety there by Danny Hill. Danny Hill plays it down the line. Ramsden has it for UNB. He's looking for some options. Decides to play it across to Lozon. Lozon knocks it in, but it's well headed by White. And now McAleer has it for the Panthers. He'll look to get this forward. Plays it forward towards Murphy, but it's rolled out of bounds. The winds kind of get a hold of that one. Law will go across and take the throw in for the Varsity Reds. Looks for Nordheim, but decides to knock it down the line towards Allen. Allen didn't see it coming. Just gave White a nudge in the back and concedes the free kick. White will leave that for O'Donnell. O'Donnell has the option to play White in early. Thinks about it. Decides not. It looks like he's going to play this long. Players lined up on the edge of the UNB 18. It is driven in. It's a good-looking cross. It's chipped in. Opportunity knocks. But it gets a foot in there. It was Copperthwaite. UNB won the header but didn't manage to direct it away from net. Fell in a dangerous spot there. And Copperthwaite did well to get a foot in there just ahead of Hogan to prevent a goal-scoring opportunity. So it looks like it's Vessi over there to take the corner for the Panthers. Panthers, four or five guys just inside the 18. Look like they've got some kind of a set players. They all go in different directions. Cross comes in, but Lozon clears. Only as far as Murphy. He can't control. And it's Lozon again that gets forward and completes the clearance. So the ball now deep inside the PEI half for the throw-in. Both teams have to start opening things up and look for a goal in this half. Throw in down the line as far as... Let's see, McAleer has it now. Allen has won the throw in. Looks like Ben Law over there to take it. Looking for some options. Finds Lozon. Plays it short. Lozon plays it back, but can't quite play it where he wants to. And that ball's out now for a PEI throw. White takes it. White knocks it into Walker. Walker plays it forward. Nice little ball into feet there. Now it's back with Murphy on the right wing. Has a chance to run or cross this in. It's a good-looking cross. But McMurray gets there just ahead of the Panthers striker. And clears that ball to safety. But a very good cross there. And Hogan just couldn't quite get on the end of it. But there is a throw-in now. White has the ball in his hands. He looks for Dawson. Checks off that option. Throws it in towards Murphy. The ball has stayed in. Still in. And now Will Allen will challenge White. White wins it. The ball's with Logan. Logan has a little bit of good skill there. Gets a cross in. It's a good-looking cross. Oh, that was a good opportunity. Good challenge by Copperthwaite there. Not sure what the free kick was given for. I'm not sure if it was offside or... Judged to be a free kick for an infringement on one of the UNB defenders. Nevertheless, Aaron McMurray in the UNB net will take this kick. Takes it short. Finds Yassim. Yassim to Ramsden. Ramsden to Nordheim. He can't control. It's won back by the Panthers. So they play it forward. A little bit of space to run now. UNB with bodies back, though, and Lozon gets a foot in and finds Bessie. Bessie tries to play it forward for Campo, but I don't think he's going to keep that in, and no, it's too strong, particularly with the wind behind it. So it looks like Lothar came in for the Panthers at halftime. Not sure who he took out. But, McDonald kicks that forward. It's not a particularly good kick. It's won by Campo. Can he put it down the line, though? And that ball is knocked out of bounds there by 23 for the Panthers, Josh Vessi. Copperthwaite has it. He's looking for some options. Usually goes to Smith in these situations. We'll see what else is on. UPI has plenty of men back covering the big frame of Smith. And Copperthwaite throws it in. It is towards Smith. It's over his head. Flicked on by Bessie. And a good chance by Will Allen. Does manage to direct it on target and win the header. But it's a fairly simple one for the Panthers keeper to collect. Looks like he's going to go long here. And he does. But it's only as far as Campo. Campo has Smith down the line. Tries to play it in. But it's deflected out of bounds by Vessie. Now Copperthwaite has the ball for the throw-in for UNB. Still these teams tied at zero. 10 minutes into the second half. Both teams desperate for a win. Copperthwaite throws it in long, but McDonald can head that clear. And but it is back with Copperthwaite now, and he'll knock it in towards Smith. But Nordheim gets a little flick. But it's cleared by the Panthers' defense. Back in, though, by UNB, and back out again by Walker. Now Ramsden plays it in towards Will Allen, but it's won back again by the Panthers. Oh, but now it's given away to Smith. Smith to Bessie. Bessie beats his man. Can he get a shot away? He does, but it's a good strike, but it's only as far right into the midsection of the Panthers keeper, and I think Bessie took a little bit of a knock on the follow-through of that. Teams searching for that opening now, UNB. The ball is flicked on there, but won back by UNB. That's a good, fairly good, solid thump in the back there by number 12, Michael Walker, on Bessie. So it is a UNB free kick. Copperthwaite strolls over. Not sure if it's going to be him or Ramsden, or maybe he'll play it short. That ball, again, having a tough time keeping it still in the wind. Might even play this short just to make you know, just to facilitate getting the ball back into play. Knocks it in to Ben Law. Law has a look. He's going to take on McAleer. Tries to slide it through for Will Allen, but the wind and the speed of that pass has taken that ball harmlessly out of play. UPI Panthers have been pretty busy this half with goal kicks and clearances. Only played 11 minutes. And he'll kick again. This one is up to just inside a half. Can't make half with the wind there. Lozon knocks it forward, but that should be collected by McDonald. And it is easily collected by McDonald. Under very little pressure there. And again, he will kick this one forward. And he's kind of shanked that. It's gone out wide. Hasn't made it to the halfway line. But the Panthers collect. And it's knocked down the line. And Copperthwaite manages to clear that off the onrushing Dawson and win the throw for UNB. So Hogan and Dawson on this near side for the Panthers. Copperthwaite and Campo for UNB. Campo gets a foot in there. Bessie has won it. Flicks it up towards Smith, but it's cut out easily by the Panthers' defense. Good turn in there by, Dawson. Back with Lozon. Lozon towards Smith. Smith's managed to get turned. This could be an opportunity for UNB. He's put in Will Allen. Will Allen can beat his man. He gets by White. Comes inside. Shot. Good shot. Good save. And the clearance by White. Very well done there by Will Allen. By the keeper, Brett McDonald, for the Panthers. Keep this game all tied at zero. Throw in for UNB. Nordheimer's thrown. Now, Nordheim will swing the cross in, I think. He does so, but it's cleared by O'Donnell, but not particularly convincingly. Bessie won it back. Copperthwaite will take the throw. Looks for Smith, but walk into the area, but he comes off the side of his foot and runs out of bounds, and that will be a goal kick for the them. Starting to get some half chances. Desperate for the goal that will secure their place in the race in Moncton. Hayes has now come on back into the game, and this time it's Brett Hogan that is leaving the field for the striker. That ball's challenged there and won by Lothar. Now it's coming through towards McMurray. Hayes has let it slip by him. McAleer turns inside his man. Not particularly convincing defending there by Lozon. Hasn't he makes some ground up front, and Copperthwaite has gone on the overlap. Smith tries to find him, but he's directed it just behind him. And the throw in over here on the near side for the Panthers. And that'll be taken by Vessi. Vessi down the line, flicked back inside. Nice work there by Lothar as he plays it forward, but Yassim has won it. Now Nordheim has it, but Nordheim's given it back to Lothar. Lothar's tried a speculative effort from about 40 yards, and that has sailed harmlessly over the bar. 40 yards into the wind, probably not going to score from there. McMurray to take the resulting goal kick for the Varsity Reds. Reds have five guys fairly far forward here. That ball is going towards Smith, gone over his head, but Bessie has judged it better, but he can't direct it towards the UNB player. And that's a nice little move there by the Panthers' number three, Jared Murphy. Plays it inside to the Dawson. Dawson plays it out to McAleer. McAleer plays it back to the fullback, who's launched it in, but it's hung up in the wind, and Yassim has won it on the edge of the 18. Bessie attempts to win that back, but it's well shielded by the PEI player. Plays in towards Murphy. Murphy tries to head that back into the box, but he's misjudged it. It's over his head, and it's resulting in a throw-in for the Varsity Reds, as the Reds attempt to get this ball forward and do some damage in the other direction. Ball played down the line. They've won another throw-in as they'll advance about 20 yards up. Vessi put that ball out of play. Now Copperthwaite throws it in towards Nordheim. That's an excellent throw. Nordheim's managed to get good control. He's got turned. Has an opportunity to set it forward. That's not a bad-looking ball if Allen can get on the end of it. Wynn just took that away, but that was just between the defense and the goalkeeper, and I think it had both of them guessing. So that could have been a real opportunity if it had just held up just a little bit more. But the Wynn is the winner in that battle. McDonald plays this one forward. That's not a bad kick. It'll get to about half, but it's won by Lozon. But referee has decided it was won unfairly and given a free kick to the Panthers. McDonald will take. As he looks for his options. He was thinking about going short there, but changed his mind. Looks like he'll knock this one in. Oh no, he has gone short, so here's Vessi. Vessi will chip that in. Well done, Ben Law, just to get his head on that. Now it's with Will Allen, but Allen's been dispossessed by White. He's half won it back, but now McAlee has taken it off him. And that's back to Hill, and Hill's knocked that forward. There's a pretty useful-looking ball there in the general direction of Lothar. Ramson had to come across, and all he can do is play that out of bounds and concede the throw-in. It's like McAleer is heading forward to take that. We've played 18 minutes in the second half of this game. We are tied at zero. Difficult conditions here at Chapman Field today. Very cold, very windy. And here's an opportunity for the Panthers, but a good tackle by Bessie. And that ball is cleared forward by Law, but it will run through to McDonald in the UPI net. McDonald looks for his options. Will decide, I think, to kick. We will see. He's kicked that forward. That's a better kick this time. And it's flicked on by the Panthers player towards Hayes. Hayes has a chance. He can't quite keep it in, though, and that ball will now be a UNB throw. So the Varsity Reds here, penned inside their own half right now, looking to gain that territorial advantage. I can see the three coaches for UNB pacing around restlessly, knowing that the season hangs in the balance. This game is an all or nothing for both teams. Now UNB has won the free kick, and Ramsden will take it. Plays it short across the field to Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite has a look up. He knocks it into a space for Smith. If Smith can get a foot on that, he can't. And McDonald collects in the Panthers' net. He'll size up his options here. Look to play this in. It's up in the air. The wind is holding that up. But it's collected by the Panthers player who had nobody around him. So somebody missed an assignment there for you and me. Murphy, trying a little bit of razzle-dazzle, seems to be enjoying himself. And it's to Vessi. Vessi inside there to Lothar. Lothar back towards Murphy, but he's been dispossessed. Now Copperthwaite plays it forward, but that's cut out by O'Donnell. He plays it back towards Murphy. He can't corral it, and UNB will have the throw. Play a little bit scrappy here at the moment. One of these two teams is going to have to get this ball settled down, and somebody is going to have to put their mark on this game. Copperthwaite throws it in long. Can't get it over Lothar. That's in the back of Hayes, and Hayes will win the free kick for the Panthers. I think it's time UNB, they're going to have to get this thing settled, get this ball settled down, and begin to play it and keep possession and open up the Panthers' defense. Most of the balls are just high and hopeful. That ball's played into the 18-yard box, and it's just almost got over the head of Ramsden, but he did just get a piece of it and slowed it up enough for Copperthwaite to complete the clearance. But it'll be a throw-in for the Panthers on this near side. And here it comes. But Lozon got a piece of it. to Campo. Campo to Smith. The ball's in the PEI half. There's a touch by White under pressure from Bessie, but he's found a man over on the right, on the right-hand side for the Panthers. Now it's back with McAleer. McAleer's dispossessed by Allen. Allen plays it in towards Nordheim. Promising opportunity here for the Reds. But Nordheim has overhit that pass to Campo. And Vessi collects with the throw-in, but that's overthrown. Now Nordheim has won it back, but he's got nobody ahead of him. He's put the ball through the legs of McDonald, but ran right into the second UPI fullback. Now Murphy has it for PEI. Bessie comes back and strips him of possession. Now Lozon has it, but Murphy's challenging him. Now Campo has a chance to go one-on-one. Has he got the speed to go by Vessi? He has. Now has he got somebody in the box he can use? It's a good-looking cross. Oh, the keeper's just got enough of it to get that ball out and behind. And that will be a corner for UNB. But a good run there by Campo. And good goalkeeping once more by the PEI goalkeeper. Corner for UNB. Ben Law strolls over to take this. How UNB would dearly love to get a goal here. Looks like warming up for UNB is Amir Razak, so we should look to see him back in the game sometime in the near future. Law plays the ball in. Oh, it's swung. It's out of bounds. You could see the wind take that ball there. It was swung out towards the six-yard line when it left his boot, and it just continued to get closer and closer to the goal line, swung all the way across the face of the goal and out of bounds on this near side. Two teams tied at zero. We are halfway through the second half. Both teams needing a win to make it through to the playoffs. Bessie is in there challenging. Lozon wins it, though, towards Smith. Smith is beaten in the air on that occasion. Lozon has won it back. Now Campo goes to try to put some pressure on the defender, who clears. Copperthwaite knocks it in. UNB playing some up-tempo stuff now. Now Bessie plays it up over the top towards Allen. Allen can't quite control it, but UNB starting to press now. See the urgency in their play. Goalkeeper McDonald will take the goal kick for the Panthers. This is where it's difficult for the Panthers in these conditions, as it's such a strong wind. It's difficult to get the ball out if UNB pressures their defense. It doesn't allow them to get the ball, play the ball out through the back, force them to kick, and the kick is hanging up around the halfway line and is a delight for defenders to attack. Here we have another one, and that is won by Ben Law. And now Bessie has it for the Reds. Bessie plays it into the corner for Campo. If Campo can keep that in, he's in a battle with Vessi. I think he's won the corner, so good work there by Campo. Corner kick to the Varsity Reds as they look for that goal that will hopefully take them through to the playoffs. It's taken short to Lozon. Lozon knocks it in. He's won it, is cleared, but only as far as Lozon again, and that's a shot that won't be remembered for its glory. Goal kick for McDonald in the Panthers' net. As he strolls over, he's taking his time. A draw will be of no use to the Panthers today. Desperate for a win, give themselves any hope of making it to the playoffs. That ball is flicked on there by Hayes, but won by Yassin, and now flicked on by Bessie. Bessie's having a strong game this second half. Campo has it now. He's got Vessi on his back, and Murphy wins it off him, but Lozon wins it back. He's found Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite knocks it forward, but first to that ball is Walker. And now it's with Smith. Smith, the Nordheim, waits for it. He didn't know that McAleer was on his back. Now White has it in the fullback for PEI. Back towards Hill, and Hill clears, but only as far as Law. Law's won it. Now it's with Bessie again. He's got some space. If he can get this ball, gets there ahead of O'Donnell. O'Donnell's still there, though. Plays a 1-2 plays it into Campo. Campo cuts back. Now he finds Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite puts it in the box, flicked on, but away by Hill, but only as far as Lozon. Lozon's got some pressure, though, by Hayes. Hayes gets a piece of that, but only as far as Yassin. Yassin plays it back into the corner. Will Allen will try to keep that in, and White is forced to clear that into the car park, and that'll be a throw in for the Varsity Reds. So they try to unlock this Panther door here and get on this score sheet. Ben Law over there to take the kick, take the throw in. Will he look long or will he look short? We'll see. Yes, he's looked short. He's found Ramsden. Ramsden back to Law. Law plays it into Allen. Allen can get turned, but that ball's easily cleared there by Dawson, but only as far as Yassim. Yassim collects for UNB. Most Panthers deep in their own half as they start to get their shape back now. McMurray has a look over towards Copperthwaite. But Copperthwaite's going to come under some pressure from Murphy. Murphy to Lozon. Lozon plays it in, but it's cut out easily by the Panthers' midfielder. Now it's into Hayes. Hayes to Lothar. Lothar has a look, looks for options, keeps possession, plays it to Vessi. Vessi's got some support down the wing. It's not the best of balls, but it is controlled by Murphy. But unfortunately, he can't keep it in bounds. Copperthwaite wins it for UNB. There is a substitute coming on here. Razak is coming on. And Smith is going off. So this is going to be require some new tactics for UNB. They're actually going to make a switch and put Will Allen up front. Allen's looking pretty lively in this game today. Razak is on the left wing, so he's a good attacking option for them too. Let's see if this will make the difference. But that one is that ball is cut out by Lothar. And O'Donnell clears it, but only as far as Ramsden. Ramsden has it now for UNB. He finds Nordheim. Nordheim's pass is a little bit careless, and Lothar picks it up to Murphy. Murphy hoiks it forward. It's won by Yassim. Only back to Lothar, and Lothar has put that ball out of bounds. PEI find it difficult to get anything going here. UNB starting to apply some pressure, starting to show some urgency in this game. Here's Copperthwaite. He throws it down the line. It's in towards Allen. Allen wins it. Can Bessie get a foot in? He does. Here's a top chance. Oh! But he's completely miscued the shot. But well done there, Bessie. I mean, he made that pretty much himself. Just couldn't quite get the finish. McDonald for PEI sets up the kick. We've now played 28 minutes of the second half. UNB needing a win here. Looked short of a playoff spot a week ago until a double loss last weekend. Now they're in trouble. Needing the goal. And this kick will be taken by O'Donnell. A free kick for the Panthers. Try to get this one back into the UNB box. It'll get held up in the wind. It's chipped in towards Lothar, but Yassim wins it. Campo clears that ball. Vessi is challenging. Looks like a little bit of obstruction there, but he gets away with it. Vessi has it, but Yassim has played it, has won it. And now Campo has it as UNB races forward. He's got options in the middle. Finds Will Allen down the line. Allen played marked by O'Donnell. O'Donnell is tight. Plays it back to Campo. Campo a little razzle-dazzle. Can he beat O'Donnell? He's got turn now. Create a little bit of space. Megs him. Can he keep that ball in bounds? He can. It's a great-looking cross. Well cleared there, though, by Walker, I think. Now a chance for Lozon. Lozon gets a shot, but it's hit a UPI defender who's cleared it. Only as far as Ben Law. Law has it. And he can only play it out of bounds, so the Panthers survive another scare. 0-0. Both teams needing the win. The earlier game was won by UPI girls, 1-0. We have a substitute coming in here for PEI. I think it's Hogan coming back into the game. It is. I'll try to see who's leaving the game. I think it's McAleer. It's not McAleer. It's Michael Walker. So Hogan's in, Walker's out. Throw in for by White. It's won by Law. It'll be another throw-in for White. As he runs forward, down the line. Law's missed it this time. Hayes has it. Seems to have overstepped it, but he has won the throw-in. Panthers' Vessi is going over to take this one. I guess it's a free kick. That's why he's wandering all the way over there to take this. So Murphy is looking short. Maybe Murphy will take it. Seems strange, though, to get your left back all the way over there and then not let him take the throw, kick. Anyway, that ball is cleared. PEI has it, though, in the back line. Just knock it forward. Law tries to win that, but can't do so. Lozon has it. Now it's with Law. knocks it forward towards Allen. Let's come on towards Nordheim. Oh, Nordheim was almost away there. Now Murphy has control of the ball for the Panthers. Turns inside Copperthwaite. Plays it through, but Law gets a foot in. Important challenge there. Lozon has it for the Reds. Goes forward, but it's deflected by the Panthers. Now they win it back. And Panthers still have it. And they've won a free kick. Good work there by Adam Lofer. As they set this up, they'll be 45 yards from UNB net. O'Donnell over there to take it. They've got four bodies just inside the box, one on the outside of the box. So everybody's fairly narrow, so we'll expect some movement. It's chipped in towards the UNB keeper, and he comes and collects that without any trouble at all. Looks for options. Finds Copperthwaite on this right-hand side. They'll see if they can work something from this. And he finds Campo. That's a good option. Campo's been dangerous down this right. He's challenged there by the number 22, Hogan. Gets it in. Nice-looking cross. Can anybody get on the end of it? Ooh, it skips right through everybody. Razak has it now. Razak versus White. Razak's got some tricks on him, and he wins the corner. So UNB hoping to get some pressure here, maybe clean head. They don't have Smith in there anymore, so that option is out, but they are bringing Yassim forward from his defensive position. He's fairly strong in the air. Ramson has stayed back, I think, on this occasion. Ball's played in. Good challenge there by the UPI defender, Logan Dawson. But Copperthwaite has it. He'll chip this cross in, is he? Actually goes low. Wins it back, though. Gets inside the box, but he's dispossessed. But he's won it back. And now there's an opportunity. But it's defended, knocked safety by the Panthers' defense. So that was a typical fullback forward play there. Give the ball away. Win it back. Knock the ball across. Couldn't get a red foot on the end of it, though. Now Copperthwaite has the throw in. He's looking for some options. Doesn't have a big target in there anymore. Throws it in. Oh, it's misplayed there by UPI, but they do bundle it clear. Now Ramson has it. Ramson will knock it in towards the far post. Flicked towards the goal by Bessie. Probably would have been better flicking that on as opposed to directing that on net, because there wasn't much pace on the effort. And that was an easy collect for Brett McDonald. We've got 33 minutes into the second half in the books now. It's still 0-0. UNB's turning up the pressure now. They've won a free kick about 40, 50 yards from goal. They'll push some bodies forward. It's almost, you know, it's not quite desperation time, but we're getting there. Ball played short to Copperthwaite. Copperthwaite plays it into Campo. Lots of space here for Campo to get a good cross in. Is he going to go by his man, or is he going to get the cross in? Oh, a little chip in. Just can't quite get to a UNB player, though. Ball cleared once more by the Panthers. Copperthwaite goes into challenge Hayes. Now Murphy has it. Murphy's got some speed, but Copperthwaite's got some experience. And Copperthwaite has won it in an unorthodox fashion. But O'Donnell has cleared that for the PI. Now it's with Lozon. Now Razak has it. Razak has a shot. Oh, and that's just whistled past the post. Chances starting to come here for the Varsity Reds. Always have to be aware on the counter-attack, though. PEI could be dangerous. McDonald will set this ball down. Hammer this forward. Hope that a PEI player can get on the end of it and maybe create a half chance himself. And then once more, the wind has blown the ball off the line. I wonder if we'll have time added on for the ball being blown off the line and having to retake free kicks today. Which would be a first. McDonald sizes this up. Knocks it in. He's kind of sliced it a little bit, but it has got to half. Murphy flicked on. Now it's off Murphy. Campo comes to collect. He's tried to go around his man and won the throw-in off Vessi. PI player is down. I'm not sure what the injury is. It's kind of hidden behind the truck from my vantage point. He's too serious. I think he may have just taken one to the midsection. If you know what I mean. There's a few people down there smiling, and he's back to his feet, so it's always the likely explanation. I wouldn't say he's shaking it off, but he seems to be walking it off. Anyway, the game will go on. Murphy will be none the worse for wear in a little while. Ball back with Yassim. Across to Ramsden. Ramsden into Nordheim. Nordheim plays a little touch into Bessie. Bessie gets turned. He's going to have a shot. He hit that one well, but it just struck the PEI defender, Colby O'Donnell. It was a big target in there. So Razak will take the corner. UMB's bringing some bodies forward. Yassim's coming into the box. He's got his hand up. He's looking for this one. Oh, we've got a sub. So Allen is going off, and Smith is coming back on just in time for this corner. This could be crucial. UMB hope so. We're under 10 minutes to play now. UMB desperately needs a goal. Razak to take. Sizes things up. Curls one in. It's a good-looking cross. Gets a... They got a flick on that. I think it was Bessie that got a piece of it, but it came off a PEI defender and out for another corner. Copperthwaite will take the corner. Looking for some options. More likely than not, we'll just cross this into the middle. Got movement into the front by Lozon. Just find Lozon. Lozon flicks it in. It's a bouncing around. No UNB player could get it. And now Murphy will plow a lone furrow up front. He tries to knock it through, but it's hit Ramsden, and Ramsden is cleared. Knocks it up towards Razak, but it's over his head and will run out of bounds. Clock ticking down now for UNB Varsity Reds. So they search for this goal that will take them through to the playoffs. Throw in for White. Throws it down the line. It's won by UNB. Law knocks it forward. That's going to run to O'Donnelly. I don't know if it'll go through to the keeper. Yes, it will. It's a little indecisive there just for a second. There might be a half chance, but collected and gathered by the PEI keeper. As he sends that one forward. It's flicked on there by Dawson. But UPEI can't retain possession. Now Razak has it. And now a UNB player is down. I think that's Ben Law. Hopefully it's not serious. But they are calling for some attention from the sidelines. He seems to be holding his chest. I don't know if he got a knee to the chest or something, or what happened there exactly. UNB's going to have a little huddle here, though, and see if they can get themselves on the same page. In fact, the coach is calling them over while Law gets some treatment. Can't really see what the problem with Law is. He's not holding the leg or anything, so he may just have the wind knocked out of him, or maybe a rib or something. So both teams having a little huddle here. It is 0-0. We've got 39 minutes played in the second half. Both teams need a win. Both teams come into this game having scored very few goals this season. UNB's only scored 10. UPI's only scored 11. So a low-scoring affair was always on the card, especially when you consider that UNB's only conceded 9 goals, whereas UPI has conceded 20. So if we were going by statistics alone, we would expect UNB maybe to nick one in the last... few minutes of this game and proceed directly to Moncton for the playoffs, which start next Friday. White has the throw-in for the Panthers. And referee Simon Murgatroyd says, let's play ball. And White throws it into Ramsden, who keeps the ball in play. He goes across to Yassin. Yassim has a look. He has Copperthwaite close. He plays it forward towards Nordheim. Nordheim flicks it through, and Razak is on it. Razak has an opportunity. Shoot. He scores! What a fantastic finish by... he's flagged for offside. He did actually, when he first received that ball, that did come through my mind that he might be offside. So, unfortunate there for UNB, but fortunate for the Panthers. It was a great finish. If only we had been onside, we could have been talking about that one for some time to come. Donald with the kick for the Panthers. UNB will have to regroup and try again. Ball knocked in, flicked on there by Logan Dawson, but only as far as Murray. Murray has a look. He's going to punt this one long. It's in towards Bessie, but it's won by Murphy. Murphy's just flicked into the midfield. Comes off the shoulder of the Akalia. Now it's on. Ooh, and Ramsden just got a foot in there. Now Murphy is challenged by Lozon. Lozon has won it for UMB to Law. Law plays it forward. Back to Ramsden. Now Murphy has a chance for a shot. It's not one of his better efforts. And that ball is in the hands of the UMB keeper. Copperthwaite for UNB. Plays it forward to Bessie. He's got plenty of space on this near side. He'll go try to go by his man or put the cross in. Likes to get outside. Plays it inside this time. Plays the ball in. There it is. Surely, yes, it is in this time. That is a goal by Galen Smith. Great little cross. Took them by surprise. UNB's up 1-0, but the game is not over. PEI will throw everything at UNB now for the last 5 minutes. We can be sure about that. But right now, we've got a lot of happy faces down there on the UNB bench and on the field wearing red shirts as UNB gets that goal to go 1-0 up. Galen Smith now has his fourth goal of the season for the Varsity Reds. We've got about 5 minutes to play, though. The watch actually says 3 minutes, but we've got some time to be added on. So now PEI will throw some bodies forward and see if they can get on equal terms. And that ball's flicked back in by Copperthwaite into a dangerous area, but Yassim clears. But Hill has it for the Panthers. Now Dawson. Dawson over to White. White has a look. He looks up long. He knocks it long. It's into the corner, but that will drift, I think, out of bounds. No, it's kept in by the Panthers player. He has an opportunity, but good play back, good hustling back there by Lozon, whose work rate has been outstanding all season. Now Razak goes past his man, takes the ball in towards the corner, knocks it forward, and he's actually won the free kick. Razak, a cagey little move there to buy his team some time. They will take their time on this, I'm sure. Is it maybe a throw-in? And looks like a substitution for UNB as Liderman is coming on. And they're bringing, you know, Razak off. Save him for next week. It looks like he's limping a little bit too. Razak, as I said earlier, has been injured a fair bit of this season. So I don't think they have a lot of confidence in his ability to go 90 minutes and would rather save him for next week than keep him out there to preserve the lead now. Looks like he's holding his hamstring again. That could be bad news for UNB. It looks like another sub for UNB. Nordheim is coming off and Beener is going on to try to hold on to this lead for the last 3 or 4 minutes of this contest. Galen Smith stooping to head that ball home at the 87-minute mark of the game. 87-minute mark of the game. Could be crucial for UNB's season. Ball thrown in. White wins it. Back out for another throw-in. Ben Law has it. Looks to throw it in again. Throws that one in towards Smith. Smith controls. Looked like he had a bit of a nudge in the back there, but PI's got away with it, but they can't keep possession. And it'll be another throw-in for UNB. As Ben Law will come across to take it. It'll take his time, I'm sure, at this stage of the game. 1-0 to the UNB men's team now. Throws that ball down the line. White gets it, flicks it out for another throw-in. But throw-ins won't do any UPI any good at this stage of the game. They've got to find a way to keep that ball in play and get it forward. Their season will end with the final whistle if the score stays as it is right now. Law throws it in to Liederman. Liederman wins the throw-in. I think that's a little bit of inexperience there by White of the PEI team. I mean, you know, it's a good defensive play to win the ball, but to give away a corner at this stage, you know, you can't afford the time. You've got to somehow try to keep that ball in play and win it that way, even if it means playing the ball back. Now UNB tries to play some more time. It looks like they have lost it in the corner, but the battle goes on, and the referee has given a free kick to PEI. But it's very deep, but they have a chance now to launch this one forward. White is there. He will put it forward. It's with Dawson to O'Donnell. O'Donnell has a chance to move forward now. Gets this ball up to a PEI player. Knocks it up. it's challenged. Coppethwaite has won it, but it's bobbling around. But Yassim gets a foot in. But still, UNB still can't clear. Yassim is injured now. Smith has it. They will just try to keep possession, knock it into the corner, knock it forward. Urbina will come forward and challenge. Keeper O'Donnell has it. Yassim is still down. Looks like he's got cramp, which could be costly at this stage of the game if we can't. McAleer now for UPEI. Plays it back to Hill. Hill knocks it forward, only as far as the right wing spot, which is vacant at this point in time. And so it will be a throw-in for UNB, and Ben Law will be over there to take it. As we move, we are into time added on now. UNB looks like they might be making a sub as Alexander Hayat comes on, or is preparing to come on for the last couple of minutes. That's a difficult situation to come on to for any defender. Hasn't played a lot of minutes this season. It's a very cold day. He's been sitting on the bench all game. You're up 1-0. Your playoff hopes lie in the balance, and all of a sudden you're going to be inserted into the center of defense. You can be sure that he's going to be nervous the first time that ball comes his way. Anyway, UNB will attempt to hang on. The message for Alex will be safety first. If that ball comes your way, be confident, put your foot through it, and clear the lines. So here we go. We are into time added on. As I mentioned, there may be a few more minutes of this before the final whistle goes. It's been a couple of subs and a couple of injuries in the last few minutes. Law knocks that one, plays that one down the line towards White. White can only get ahead on it, and once more he puts the ball out of bounds, which will suit UNB and will not suit the Panthers' needs right now. Law strolls forward to take this. He'll once more likely go down the line and try to buy some more time. He plays it down in towards Smith. Smith controls, plays it back to Law, and plays it back to Smith. This is good work by UNB. But now it's given away by, can't see who. PI has it. They'll hack that forward. And this is Alex Haight's first chance to touch it. And it's a good one. Safety first. Knocks that ball in. But it's back by the Panthers. And now can they win it? Win a free kick. Win something to give themselves a chance. Lozon once more. That steady defensive midfielder. But it's knocked forward into the corner for McAleer. Can he corral it? Can he get past Law and make something happen? Law actually gets a foot in. He's given away the corner, so this could be the last gasp effort for the Panthers. They will bring everybody forward. The goalkeeper is coming forward for the Panthers. Will he come all the way? Yeah, he's getting the nod. In you come, big fella. See if you can get on the end of this. So tense moments for the UNB defense. The cross comes in. It's near post, and it's actually, in fact, didn't even make it into the 18-yard box. What a disappointment for the Panthers. And the goalkeeper will run the 110 yards back to his own net. Aaron McMurray for UNB prepares to take the goal kick, hoping that Simon Murgatroyd will whistle this down as soon as this ball reaches the halfway line. And there's some chatter going on between Murgatroyd and White. I'm not sure what it's all about. Ball is knocked in towards Smith, but it's over him. Now it's with PEI again. They'll knock it forward, but Lozon got a foot in. Now Campo loses out to Vessi, and that looked to be off the shoulder of Murphy, but it's across towards McAleer. If he can keep this in, it could be one last opportunity for the Panthers. McAleer has a chance to run at Liederman. Now it's into the corner. Can they get the cross in? No, they can't. It's actually gone out for a goal kick. So good defending there by Ramsden. And surely that will do it for this game. And the Varsity Reds will be into the playoffs. And the season will be over for the UPEI Panthers. In these difficult conditions here at Chapman Field, we are well into stoppage time. McMurray will take this kick in his own good time. Here it is. And he knocks it up. And once more, Murgatroyd does not go for the whistle. And PEI has won that and knocked it forward. And now he has called the game. And UNB will be in the playoffs thanks to a 87th-minute goal by Galen Smith as he stooped to head that one home. very well contested game there, pretty even, very, very difficult conditions, but UNB will prevail, and that will guarantee them a spot in the playoffs. We'll have to wait and see where they get seeded, but they are in, UPEI is out, and that will leave a contest between Memorial, Cape Breton, and Moncton to see who joins them in the playoffs, along with St. FX, St. Mary's, and Dalhousie, who are all pretty much guaranteed a spot. Well, that's it for me, Steve Harris, from Chapman Field here this afternoon. And I've certainly enjoyed doing the commentary for the Varsity Reds this season. And hopefully we'll be back again next year.
My knees would work too.